All right, so giving out the Threadripper another test now that I'm back. I'm starting out with Boxcutter here. For some reason, it seems to be feeling a little slow. What is making that? Oh God, it is a little slow. All right, new blender, who dis, take two, action. All right, so the view is rotating fairly nimbly. So we'll just go inside view. Chaw box, press B, and just do a quick cut on the side. We'll also do a cut here. Press T, bring it in. Draw a little slit here. We'll just roll that over. And from here, I'm just going to draw another box, but I'm going to press A, and then press E to extrude it, the opposite direction. We'll get something like that. We'll just sink that down, and what I want to do is shift deduplicate. And then select the cube that we added, press Q. Difference. Then of course the wire one. We want to go ahead and hide that. But now our gray shape has been reduced to that. So if I go to custom shape and press C, now you see that we can repeat that. So I'm just going to draw one of those right here. Draw another one right here. And as you can see, as we revisit these corridors, they get easier and easier because of the tool and their enhancements and prophecies being realized. But I'm pretty pleased with the state of Boxcutter as of right now. However, we always have more work to do. So continuing on. We'll just go back to box. We'll just draw another shape in here that we'll rework around. This one will be something like this. Press T. We'll draw a box. Bring it down our X. Draw that out. We'll bring another box down. Do a teeth that cut around it. And then we'll just do a couple of random extrusions. Around these random extrusions, we'll bring down another box. We'll press T. Bring another box down, and as you can see, I'm pretty much pressing the same buttons over and over without ever stopping. Just drawing boxes, pressing A, pressing T, and with this, we can just start in this corner, draw a box accurately, press A, and press E, bring it down ever so slightly. And this is our box, so we'll just bring that down a little bit more. We'll take the whole shape, shift deduplicate, select our gray, difference, one to get back to this layer. We'll go back to custom shape, press C, and that's our custom shape now. And here I am, repeating that area once again. So the moral of the story, Boxcutter just makes it easier. This video is more of a test. I didn't intend this to actually be a box cutter video. I just wanted to just goof off and test the AMD Threadripper now that I finally got it back. Spoiler alert, it was a cooler issue. After putting a new cooler in it, now the computer is back. RTX back in it, so now I have the dual GPUs, so I'm back to cooking with gas. So now back to hitting these tutorials very hard. So we'll go ahead and look at it in the render, go back to shaded. You know, one thing I can't live without a bevel, so let's add a bevel. Truly regrettable, but let's try it. There we go, 6. And we'll bring up the bevel helper. It's a good old friend. Divide it by half. Let's divide it by half. Let's divide it by half one more time. Alright, and let's add a weighted normal on top of that. And now the shading is good. So now let's actually jump over in the render and take a look. And so, we could probably make our bevel life a little bit easier. All these micro cuts are just going to wreak havoc on the bevel modifier working at an angle. Also, each of these cuts are in here without any sort of support edges. Just to demonstrate, let's multiply it by 2, bring it back until it's looking bad. And we want to actually look at this piece. Or even let me tap that, but there we go. Alright, actually we need to go back into object and then apply the bevel. And then go back into edit. So we'll just apply the bevel real quick. It lets me. Alright, thank you. And now we'll go into edit mode. I wonder what this hang is. I'm assuming that it could be something going on with the render. I'm probably doing something Blender doesn't want me to do. I don't blame him. So we'll put a loop. Right here, and let's jump this baby into local mode. It's the only way to get any interactivity out of this thing. I don't remember Blender actually being so slow at that particular part of the operation, but now we have a line going all the way through this, which just helps the bevel out. You can see that now it works at a greater width, but up here we can see that it breaks down a little bit in certain areas, and really there's nothing that can be done for that except for lowering your bevel, you know, because your bevel amount's going to be dependent on, and this is also where the helper comes in handy. You can see that there's actually so much geometry here that controlling it via bevel just isn't optimal. That will do, even though it's a little bit of an overlap. And bada bing, bada boom. So that'll conclude my video test, and I'll see you guys next time.